We have to find solutions, mobility solutions to respond to the needs of our citizens. And mobility has a big impact. We're talking about an effect on local pollution, on noise. We talk about how is the city organized. Mobility, transportation takes a lot of space on our streets. When we talk about our big European goal to be carbon neutral in 2050, today mobility plays about a third of our CO2 is associated with transport and mobility. We have to find new innovative solutions to provide what we need, but do it with these ecological and constraints.
We really want to bring back the human factor in mobility. Design a city that's really made for people. It's not just traffic going through, but where people are can live and enjoy and have public space. Urban logistics is so diverse. You know, every package or every thing that you transport almost needs a tailored approach and needs to be put on the right boat or on the right train or on the right car or on the right bike. Autonomous vehicles could be, you know, one part of the puzzle.
Cities are facing an increase in number of deliveries. Technology and automation could help improve those flows, but it still has to be included in a general framework.
If we look at Brussels, you start to see that there is indeed a kind of very good ecosystem for putting light, autonomous, electrical vehicle in this kind of urban environment. I think the ecosystem is starting to get ready for the deployment of the technology. Also because people want to have clean, they want to have, no stress environment, and they want to be surrounded by a pedestrian and by bicycle and not by, vehicles, driving fast around them. We are coming to a time where the ecosystem is starting to get right for, autonomous logistics as well.
We've seen really two different ways of approaching it. If I can make the comparison to the way the US is treating autonomous vehicles, I think there's been a lot of hype. America is, I think, very car-centered. We're more looking at, what are the potential benefits also for other modes. In Brussels, the way we've so far approached autonomous vehicles has been very focused on public transport. How can public transport in the first place improve with autonomous vehicles? The hype has gone a bit down. And I think in that sense, it's interesting that Ziegler now comes with this proposal, a family company of Brussels capital region, with an international outlook. Companies like Ziegler coming aboard, it gives it a bit more credibility, I'd say, because based on your, experience with urban logistics, with logistics in general, I think the chances of success are then also a bit higher. If you're not just living on this hype, but if you're actually, really trying to do this from your core business and seeing how you can sustainably change your core business for the future.